Good morning, my dear friends. Today we are going to explore Faro. I want to show you three nice things that you can do in Faro. Every morning should start with a nice cup of coffee and, if possible, with an amazing view. For that, the first place I'm recommending you to visit is the Faro Hotel. The Faro Hotel is situated right in the port area and it's very easy to spot. It has this amazing rooftop with an amazing view, which makes every coffee or breakfast wonderful in the morning. It's really a very nice experience. As you can see, the things you are hearing are not exactly matching with the image. Why? Because my microphone had a little bit of glitch. I have to change this microphone also. Also, I was telling you about the nice breakfast they have. They serve breakfast for the guest hotels, but also you have the option to buy the breakfast. I think I asked and it's 15 euros. It's a 4-star hotel, so the prices can be a little bit high. But again, Faro is a touristy town and you will find high prices all over Faro. So if you find yourself in Faro early in the morning, this is a nice place to drink your coffee and to see this wonderful view over the Ria Formosa Park. From here, you can take the boats and visit the islands, Isla Desierta, Culatra, Isla de Farol, that surrounds and they are so close to the Faro area. But we advise to take the ferry that is run by the government, by the state, because the other ones are just very expensive. So if you take the one run by the government, it will cost you 3 euros per person one way and 5 euros per person return. But if you take the other ones, it's gonna cost you between 5 euros per person just one way and it can go up to 30 euros. So of course there are more expensive boats and more fancy boats, but if you just want to go for a stroll on the island, my advice is to take the government ferry. Now we are going to lunch, and the first place I wanted to show you is Playa de Faro. And why I chose to show you this place and eat there with all the restaurants here in Faro is because the restaurants here in Faro are mainly touristy. If you are not a local and you don't know a good place to eat, the majority of the restaurants are touristy and of course very expensive. I like the atmosphere there, I like the vibe, I like that I'm right on the beach and I can look at the water, and I don't know, I've been there and I know the place. And also I wanted to show you that place because the first three times I went to Faro I didn't even know that there is such a place as the Faro Beach, and it has a lot of restaurants and a laid-back vibe, and maybe some of you are interested to know that this place also existed. And it's not that far, we are going by car, 15 minutes from Faro. There are also buses to go there. I hope we will get a table because it's very crowded these days, a lot of tourists here. So this is Playa de Faro. It is a stretch of land, of sand actually, where you can find many houses, vacation houses, many restaurants and beaches. It's a very laid-back feeling and very vacation feeling, and this is why I like this place rather much. This is the second time I come here. Let's go now to eat something. You can end the day at the same rooftop, order yourself a nice cocktail and watch the sunset. But we chose to go home because frankly I'm very very tired from all the wind and the heat. It seemed like all the videos start in a very bold way and then I seem to never be up to make a real ending. Most of my videos don't have an end and I wanted to sit down and have an end for this vlog. I guess there are many other things you can do in Faro. You can visit more of the streets of the old town, you can visit the museum, you can sit down at the many many cafes and restaurants, you can go on a trip on a boat on the islands. There are so many islands to see, there are so many trips to be made, but I wanted to make a program from a more realistic
side of things, because I don't really like to be that tourist that goes from one attraction to another and doesn't have time to do really anything in the day, then just go rush through things to do. If you just choose one or two things to do, you are more relaxed that way and you get to soak in the atmosphere of the place you are visiting. But this is just my opinion. When I was younger, I was that person who was rushing to all the things to do on a to-do list that I prepared months and months before I took the vacation. Maybe it's also about the fact that now I'm not really on vacation. My vacations, which are more like staying in Portugal for a limited period of time and then go back to my country. I'm staying here like 1 month or 2 months. They are not really vacations, more like my life now. And I'm not really feeling the pressure of the time of visiting everything in a town in one sweep. Don't forget to subscribe, because you are helping me so much with YouTube algorithm. You are helping other people like you to see my videos, because if you are not engaging with my content, YouTube thinks that you are not liking my content. I understand. I watch a lot of videos and I don't subscribe to the authors and I don't like the videos. Even if I like the videos, because I don't know, I have other things to do, I don't know why. But if I'm not engaging with their content, YouTube thinks the content is no good if someone doesn't tell YouTube that the content is good. I hope this explanation is not too long, but there are not many people who know that. Unless you are a YouTuber, you don't know that. So maybe knowing that, you will like the video and subscribe to my channel to support me in that way if you like my videos. Thank you very much, and I will see you in my next one. Bye.